areas of the body. And the fact of the matter is I need to break it down for you. You need to understand what happens when we produce energy. How do we truly produce energy, and why does a ketogenic diet and why does fasting improve mitochondrial efficiency? All right. So first and foremost, let's take a look at the actual diagram of the mitochondria. So the mitochondria inside of a cell has two different membranes. It has this outer membrane that's right here, okay? And that outer membrane really just serves as basically the shell, okay? It's protecting it, and it's also allowing different electrons to come in and out and creating this gradient between positively charged electrons and negatively charged electrons. I'll explain all that in a minute. But then what makes a mitochondria extremely unique is this inner membrane, okay? So outer membrane here, inner membrane here. You see how it's all squiggly? The reason that it's squiggly is because it's very, very efficient. The reason that it's efficient is because it has a lot more surface area. See, the body has evolved over such time that they've determined, well, in order to pack more energy into a single cell, we need to combine as much surface area as we possibly can. So it's created this inner membrane that has all these squiggles in it. Surface area is maximized because we have all this surface area. You'll understand in a minute when I start explaining how that inner membrane is so important, but all the energy is created there. That's where the combination of oxygen takes place. That's where everything is actually created. So these folds increase that surface area. This, known as the cristae, is basically just the actual characteristic of the squiggles. So the little curves like here are called the cristae. They're not really a metabolic function. It's just more a terminology that explains how it's actually structured, okay? Then we have the matrix. The matrix is the fluid that is inside this inner membrane. And inside this matrix, you have water and you have different proteins, in this case enzymes, that break down and cause different electric charges and non-charges to occur. Basically, the mitochondria is all just a balance of the electron transport chain. In short, it's basically a balance of negative and positively charged things going on that are creating energy and creating heat. I'll get to that in just a second too. First of all, it's important that you know that 90% of the energy that we create is created in the mitochondria, whether it's in a brain cell, liver cell, whatever, they're everywhere. And they have so many of them, they're producing so much energy. But it's like a digestive system, okay? Think of it as your cell's digestive system. So we have a digestive system. Whenever we eat things, we start breaking things down, our body extracts the proteins, the fats, the carbs, it does certain things with them. Well, think of this as a second digestive system. It's your cell's stomach and digestive system. That's all it is, okay? So all the sugars, the fats, and the proteins that we eat get essentially converted into a truly usable energy here, ATP, okay? So it all starts with cellular respiration, and that's what we're gonna focus on today, okay? And it all starts with the matrix, which again, is this liquid portion, that's the enzymes and the water. And they end up digesting the pyruvate, or the acetyl coenzyme A, that is broken down from the sugars, fats, and protein, okay? So they end up breaking it down even more, and then it combines with enzymes in this fluid. And that's where the magic starts to happen, okay? It actually can break oxygen back down to its total primal state and start breaking all this stuff down into water. The mitochondria is the only place that can take all this energy and all these molecules and just turn them into water. It's the only place that occurs. That's literally the cellular respiration, as it's called. It's the only place in the body where water is created. That we have positively charged exteriors of the mitochondria and negatively charged interiors. That is how we create energy. ATP spins, which causes ADP to combine with phosphate, which creates ATP, which is energy. Again, I'm paraphrasing here, but essentially all it means is that electricity spins this little booger right here and ends up creating energy. This turbine right here is like a motor. It's just the revolutions per minute, just like your car, except it's moving more at like 7 to 12,000 revolutions per minute. It's moving very, very fast, creating a lot of energy and a lot of heat. And that heat is how you burn fat, my friends. So when I start talking about whole mitochondrial efficiency and how ketones and fasting actually end up creating more mitochondrial efficiency, it means this whole system moves easier and faster. Okay, it makes it so that this whole process is smoother, has less resistance, and thereby can create more heat.